दोबारा से क्या
नहीं
क्या हो
नहीं
गया। तो बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन। आई एम डॉक्टर कमल बाबर फ्रॉम पैथोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट। सो माय डियर स्टूडेंट, वी विल कंटिन्यू द डिस्कशन ऑफ ए सो बेटा वी विल कंटिन्यू द डिस्कशन ऑफ अ रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम। ओके, होप यू ऑल नो अबाउट द नॉर्मल एनाटॉमी ऑफ अ रेस्पिरेशन सिस्टम। सो बेटा, इन अ रेस्पिरेटरी यूनिट we can divide the respiratory chapter into two types, the new two topics, the non-neoplastic and the neoplastic. So first of all, we will discuss the non-neoplastic condition of a lung. So beta, in a non-neoplastic conditions of a lung, the most important is the COPD, which we call a chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. Okay, so basically beta, the obstructive lung diseases are characterized by an increase in our resistance to air flow. Beta, please keep it in your mind that it is due to increase in resistance to the air flow due to partial or complete obstruction at any level, from trachea and large bronchi to the terminal bronchi and the respiratory bronchiole. Clear? So beta, in a obstructive lung disease, which we also said to be a COPD, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, there is a obstruction at any level, from trachea to the respiratory bronchiole. Clear beta? And there is a increase in resistance to the airflow. Clear? And the conditions or a disease of COPD include emphysema, asthma, chronic bronchitis, bronchiectasis, and bronchiolitis. Okay, anyone can ask about the disease, name the diseases which includes an obstructive lung disease. So you must know that the obstructive lung disease includes the conditions like emphysema, chronic bronchitis, asthma, bronchiectasis, and bronchiolitis. Clear? So beta, this image is from your book Robbins, and it shows that any chronic injury, any persistent injury like smoking, causes damage to the airway. And like in emphysema, there is basic defect in a alveolar wall. There is a destruction of the alveolar wall. Okay, and this destruction in the emphysema is responsible for a overinflation of the lung. Clear? While in a chronic bronchitis is associated with the productive curve, and there is a major role of a inflammation. Clear? While in the asthma is basically a reversible condition. Okay, and it is triggered by a hyper responsiveness of allergen or infections. Clear? Now, beta, I will give you a brief review of all the COPD conditions. Then we will discuss later on one by one in detail. Clear? So now, beta, COPD is basically the chronic bronchitis. Anatomically, it involves the side bronchus. Okay, it involves the bronchus, and the pathological changes is associated with a mucus gland. Beta, please, please keep it in your mind that chronic bronchitis, in a chronic bronchitis, there is a abnormality in a mucus gland. There is a hyperplasia of a mucus gland. There is a hypertrophy of a mucus gland. There is a hypersecretion of a mucus gland. Okay, and the chronic bronchitis is mostly seen in a tobacco smokers, or it may occur due to a pollutants. And the sign and symptoms are cough and sputum production. Clear? The other disease is bronchiectasis, and anatomically the bronchiectasis involves the side bronchus. Clear? And it is associated with the airway dilatation and scarring. okay, and it is associated with the persistent or severe infection. Beta, this infection, keep it in your mind that this infection is a clue of bronchiectasis. ठीक है, then the sign and symptoms of bronchiectasis is cough, purulent sputum and fever. Okay, in a scenario if the word fever, infection is used, then you must know that it may be associated with bronchiectasis. Clear? Now the asthma. Beta, asthma anatomically involves the side bronchus. Okay, and pathologically it is associated with the smooth muscles hyperplasia. Clear? There is an increased mucus production and there is a associated inflammation. And the asthma is basically an immunological response. It is basically a hypersensitivity response. And it is clinically it shows a episodic wheezing, cough and dyspnea. Clear? Now the emphysema. Emphysema is basically beta a disease of a acinus. It involves the acini. And in which there is a dilatation of the air spaces. There are enlarged air spaces due to destruction of the wall. Clear? And the causes include the tobacco, smoke, and the sign and symptoms are dyspnea. The bronchiolitis or the small airway disease is basically involves the bronchioles and it is associated with inflammatory scarring. Clear? So till now, we are able to know about that in a respiratory system, we must know about the obstructive diseases. There are different types of obstructive diseases. You must know about the names like emphysema, chronic bronchitis, asthma, and bronchiectasis. These all are obstructive lung disease. Clear? And if anyone asks, what do you mean by obstructive lung disease? Then we must know that in obstructive lung disease, there is a obstruction. There may be a complete or partial obstruction at any level from trachea to the respiratory bronchiole. Clear? Then you must know about the specific features of chronic bronchitis, emphysema, asthma. So now we will discuss one by one in detail. Now, first of all, emphysema. Beta, emphysema by a definition is characterized by a irreversible. Keep it in your mind, irreversible. It is actually an irreversible enlargement of the air spaces distal to the terminal bronchiole, and it is accompanied by a destruction of the air wall without obvious fibrosis. Four things, irreversible. Number one, enlargement of the air spaces. Number two, distal to the terminal bronchi. Clear? And there is without obvious fibrosis. Okay? There is enlargement of the air spaces, distal to the terminal bronchi. Okay? And there is a destruction of the wall without fibrosis. Clear? So, beta, this definition of emphysema is very important. Please be prepared the definition of emphysema. Clear? Now, beta, there are different types of emphysema. Okay, or we can classify emphysema according to their anatomical distribution. Anyone can ask the name the different types of emphysema and how we can classify the emphysema. So you must know that there are different types of emphysema and we divide the emphysema on the basis of their anatomical distribution. Like centriacinar type, panacinar type, paraseptal type and irregular type. Okay. We will discuss in detail one by one. So, beta, this is the different, this picture is basically from your book, Robbins, and it shows that the centriacinar type involves the center part of the alveolar system, while the panacinar type involves the whole pulmonary lobe. It involves the whole alveolar duct. Clear? Okay. Now, beta, centriacinar type. Centriacinar type is basically a centrilobular type in which there is a central or a proximal part of the acini is involved that is formed by a respiratory bronchioles. Okay, in centriacinar type, central part is involved, which we call a respiratory bronchiole. Okay, and distal alveoli are spared. There is no involvement of distal alveoli. Clear? And this type is seen in a heavy smokers. ठीक है, एज वी नो दैट इम्फाइजीमा इज एसोसिएटेड विद द स्मोकर्स एंड अमंग द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ इम्फाइजीमा द सेंट्रल एसिना टाइप इज स्पेसिफिकली एसोसिएटेड विद द क्रॉनिक स्मोकर्स. ओके, एंड द लीजन्स आर मोर कॉमन इन द अपर लोब, particularly in the apical segment. Clear? Beta, keep it in your mind that the site in a emphysema, the definition, different types, and the location is very important. Like the sensory acinar type, central. It involves the central part. It involves the proximal part. It involves the respiratory bronchioles. And it is mostly seen in heavy smokers. The location is very important. It involves the upper part, upper lobe of the lung, apical segment. Clear? Beta, in a scenario, anyone can ask that a chronic smoker is presented with a destruction of the alveolar wall and there is a dilatation of the air spaces. And which part of the lung is mostly involved? You must know that in a heavy smokers, in a type of emphysema, mostly the sensory acinar type, and it involves the apical segment. Clear? Now, the pan acinar type, the pan lobular type. Beta, basically, the pan lobular type or a pan acinar type in which the acina are uniformly enlarged. Whole, pan means whole, all. All the acina are involved. Acinae are uniformly enlarged from the level of the respiratory bronchiole to the terminal blind alveoli. Clear? Pan refer to the entire acinus. Now, the distal acinae, as the name indicated, distal, it is actually the paraseptal. Para means corner. Okay, so it involves the proximal portion is normal, while the distal part is involved. Clear? In the central acinar, proximal. In a pan acinar, whole. In a distal acinar, the distal part, the para part, the distal part is involved. And this distal part is adjacent to the pleura. And it is seen in the upper half of the lung. Okay, beta, keep it in your mind. Sensory acinar, upper part. Para, septal or para acinar is mostly involving the lower lobe of the lung, while the distal acinar involving the upper half. Okay, central acinar and distal acinar involving the upper half, while the pan acinar, involving the lower lobe of the lung. Clear? So, there in a distal acinar type, there are multiple continuous and large spaces. There are multiple cyst-like spaces are formed. Okay, a lung hai, uske lower part pe involvement hui hai by emphysema, which we call a distal acinar type, and there may be a formation of a coronal port. There may be a formation of a multiple small cyst-like structure, and these cyst-like structure may be ruptured. As we know that the distal acinar, I already told you that the distal acinar is near to the pleura. Okay, so whenever there is a rupture of these cysts, this rupture may cause the formation of a pneumothorax, spontaneous pneumothorax. Okay, beta, this point is very, very important. In a MCQ, in a SEQ, in a VIVA, anyone can ask about complication of emphysema. Anyone can ask, is the pneumothorax seen in emphysema? Then, yes, spontaneous pneumothorax can be seen in an emphysema, especially in a distal acinar type. Clear? And there is a spontaneous pneumothorax. Now, the irregular emphysema. As the name indicated, it is irregular type. The acina is irregularly and it is associated with sparing. Clear? Now, beta, as you can appreciate it that this is the image of a lung and it shows a marked emphysematous changes in the central part. While the surrounding or a periphery acinus is normal, it is spared. While in a pan acinar type, all the pulmonary, entire pulmonary lobule is involved. Clear? Now, the pathogenesis of emphysema. So, beta, till now, you are able to know about the what is obstructive lung disease. You must know that in a respiration, there are neoplastic and a non-neoplastic condition. In a non-neoplastic condition, there are different conditions like restrictive lung disease, like obstructive lung disease, like pneumonia, etc., etc. In a, keep it in your mind that in obstructive lung disease, different conditions like emphysema, asthma, chronic bronchitis, bronchiectasis. Okay. Now, what is emphysema, what are the different types of emphysema, what are the causes of emphysema, and what are the main which type is associated with which side of lung. Okay, now the pathogenesis of emphysema, why emphysema is occur or how emphysema is occur, how the damage of an alveolar wall is seen in emphysema. Basically, the factors that influence the emphysema includes the inflammatory mediators and the leukocytes. There are leukotrienes, beta 3, leukotrienes B4, interleukin 8, and tumor necrotic factors. These factors is responsible for the attraction of the macrophages and inflammatory cells from the circulation. Okay, due to a chronic injury, better keep it in your mind that due to a chronic injury, these three factors release. Which factors? Leukotrienes B4, interleukin 8, and tumor necrotic factor. Number one is chronic injury. Chronic injury ki wajah se factor release hue. Tino, leukotrienes B4, interleukin 8, and tumor necrotic factor. These factors causes the activation of your macrophages from the circulation to the site of injury. Hemotactic factor. And these macrophages then causes the destruction of the wall. Okay, the second factor is the proteases, anti-proteases imbalance. Very, very important. And this proteases, anti-proteases imbalance is mostly seen in a pan-SNR type of a emphysema. Okay, beta, this is frequently asked that among the causes of emphysema, which causes is associated specifically with a pan-SNR type? So, I repeat it again that proteases, anti-proteases imbalance is responsible for the development of a pan-SNR type. Okay. Now, the several proteases are released from the inflammatory cells and epithelial cells that break down the connective tissue component. Okay. In some patients who develop emphysema, there is a relative deficiency of anti-proteases. Beta, as we know that the proteases is responsible for the breakdown of the proteins, okay? And the antiproteases decrease the level of the proteases and they are protective. But in emphysema, there is a deficiency of antiproteases. Whenever there is a deficiency of antiproteases, then the proteases level will be high and causes the destruction. Clear? Now, as you can appreciate it that the pathogenesis of emphysema shows whenever there is a chronic injury, like a smoking, causes the release of a reactive oxygen species. This reactive oxygen species causes the inactivation of the antiproteases level, like antiproteases level, which causes the increased level of your proteases, like elastase. And this elastase then causes the tissue damage by activation of the macrophages. Clear? So now the other causes include the oxidative stress like substance in tobacco smoke, alveolar damage, and inflammatory cells produce oxidant which increase the tissue damage and inflammation. Clear? Infection may play a role for the development of emphysema. Although infection does not play a role directly, but bacterial or viral infection may increase associated inflammation and chronic bronchitis. The patient with a genetic deficiency of antiproteases, alpha-1 antitrypsin deficiency. What? Alpha-1 antitrypsin deficiency. The patient having a deficiency of alpha-1 antitrypsin have an increased tendency to develop emphysema. Okay. Now, the alpha-1 antitrypsin is normally present in the serum, tissue fluids, and macrophages. It's a major inhibitor of proteases, especially the elastase, secreted by the neutrophil during inflammation. Clear? So patient with alpha-1 antitrypsin deficiency develop emphysema. Other genetic variants like nicotinic acetylcholine receptors, etc. So beta, factors which contribute in airway obstruction emphysema are goblet cell hyperplasia, inflammatory infiltrate in the bronchial wall, thickening of the bronchial wall, and then finally the destruction. Clear? So, in our pathogenesis, I repeat it again, in our pathogenesis of emphysema, there is a role of inflammation, especially the leukotrienes B4, interleukin 8, and tumor necrotic factors, which causes the activation of the macrophages and causes the hemotactic factors to come and causes the destruction of the alveolar. Then there is a alpha-1 antitrypsin deficiency. is may causes the emphysema and antiproteases deficiency. Clear? Now the beta grow, now the morphology. Beta, please keep it in your mind that morphology means gross feature as well as microscopic feature. Theek hai? If anyone asks about the morphology of emphysema, then you must know that you must tell about the gross features as well as the microscopic feature. Okay, gross features means the which we can see from the naked eye. Okay, so morphologically, in a gross, the emphysema, the lung become voluminous, the enlarged lung. Upper two-thirds of the lungs are more severely affected. Large apical bleeds or bulla, okay, cyst-like thing, are more characteristic of irregular emphysema and distal acinar emphysema. Large alveoli can be seen on the surface of the lung. And microscope, whether aapko gross pe kya mila, there are multiple bullas, blisters, voluminous lung, increased size of lung, clear? And microscopically beta, there is a large alveoli, irregular large alveoli separated by a thin septa, okay? With a thin focal central lobular fibrosis. Loss of attachment of the alveoli to small airway is seen. And pores of cones are large and septas appear to be floating or protrude blindly into the air space. Beta, basically, isme air spaces enlarge ho jayenge and these air spaces are lined by a thin wall. Okay, and the pores of cone in a normal lung is responsible for a communication between the two alveoli. Whenever the alveoli are enlarged and the wall becomes thin, these pores of cones are look like that they are floating or protruding into the alveolar spaces. Okay. Now, you in this microscopic image, beta, you can appreciate it that the alveolar spaces are large. Okay, one genus of alveolar spaces, these alveolar spaces are enlarged and they are lined by a thin septa. Okay. Now, as alveolar walls are destructed, there is a decrease in the capillary bed area. With advanced disease, there are large abnormal air spaces, bleeds, and bullas, which compress the respiratory bronchioles and vasculature of the lung. Clear, and the clinical features are the cough and wheezing, weight loss may be seen in the later stage, and the patient chest is barrel shaped. Clear? So, there are some other form of emphysema, which we call a compensatory emphysema. Okay, beta, in a compensatory emphysema, basically this term is used to designate the dilatation of the alveoli in response to loss of a lung. In response to compensation of a loss of the lung. Lung ka ek structure jo hai wo compensate, wo loss ho gaya, usko compensation ke liye dusra area jo hai wo dilate ho gaya. Hyper expansion of the lung parenchyma following a surgical removal of a diseased lung. Clear? Now, the obstructive or over-inflation lung, maybe the lung expand because air is trapped in it. Okay, obstruction ki wajah se the air is trapped inside the lung and due to this obstruction, there is a over-inflation. Bullous emphysema, large subpleural bleeds or bulla may more than 1 centimeter can occur in any form of emphysema near the apex. Okay, interstitial emphysema, entrance of the air into the stroma of the lung, mediastinum or a subcutaneous tissue may cause tears in the alveolar tissue and provide a channel of air entry into the stroma of the lung. Clear? So you can appreciate it that in a cross picture, this is a lung and it shows a multiple bullous formation. So these are the bullous or blisters formation. Clear? Now, beta. Till now, we know that there are an obstructive lung disease. Emphysema is one of the obstructive lung disease. Okay. Beta, you must know the definition of emphysema. The four things are very important. One is irreversible. Number two is distal to the terminal bronchi. Number third is destruction of the alveolar wall without obvious scar. Then you must know about the different type of emphysema: centriacinar type, panacinar type, distal acinar type, irregular type. Clear? Then you must know about the pathogenesis, how emphysema is. Basically, there is a role of inflammation, interleukin 8, human necrotic factor, leukotriene, antiproteases. Okay, anti-tryptase deficiency. Clear? Anti-proteases deficiency. Okay, then you must know about the cross feature, large lung, voluminous lung. Okay, bullous formation, blister formation, and you must know about the microscopic features. Large ear spaces lined by a thin ductus. Clear? This is all about the emphysema. Now we will discuss the second obstructive lung disease, that is chronic bronchitis. Beta, by a definition, chronic bronchitis is defined as persistent cough with sputum production for at least 3 months in at least 2 consecutive years in the absence of any other identifiable cause. Beta, definition is very, very important. Please prepare your proper definition of chronic bronchitis. Persistent cough. Okay, sputum with sputum production for 3 months in at least 2 consecutive years in the absence of any other identifiable cause. Okay, we prepare the proper definition of chronic bronchitis. Clear? Chronic bronchitis is seen basically in a habitual smokers or inhabitants of smoke-laden cities. Basically, a pollutant is responsible for the development of a chronic bronchitis. When chronic bronchitis persists for years, it may accelerate decline in lung function, leading to a cold pulmonary or heart failure, or causes an atypical metaplasia and dysplasia of respiratory epithelium, which may lead to the carcinoma. But it is a less likely complication. Clear? So now, the pathogenesis. Why? How chronic bronchitis is occurring? Basically, beta, the initiating factors in chronic bronchitis is exposure to the noxious or irritating inhaled substance such as tobacco smoke and dust from the grain, cotton. Clear? And as I already told you, beta, keep it in your mind that in the pathogenesis of chronic bronchitis, mucus gland, there is some defect in a mucus gland. There is a hypertrophy, hyperplasia of a mucus gland, which causes the hypersecretion of the mucus. So mucus secretion, the earliest features of chronic bronchitis is hypersecretion of mucus in a large airway with hypertrophy of submucous gland in the trachea and bronchi. Clear? With the passage of time, there is a marked increase in goblet cells in here. Small airways, small bronchi and bronchioles, leading to increased mucus production that contribute to the airway obstruction. Okay, histamine and interleukin 13 are involved in mucus hypersecretion. Okay, now the inflammation. Inflammation also play a role. Inhaling that induced chronic bronchitis causes the cellular damage, leading to acute and chronic inflammatory response involving neutrophils, lymphocytes, and macrophages. Long-standing inflammation and fibrosis involving small airways can also lead to chronic airway obstruction. Now, the infection does not initiate chronic bronchitis, but is significant in maintaining it may be critical in producing acute exacerbation. Cigarette smoke not only damage the airway lining, but also interfere with the ciliary action of the epithelium, preventing the clearance of mucus and increase the risk of infection. But at this point is very, very important. Okay, that as we know that, as I already told you, that there is a role of a mucus gland and abnormality in a mucus gland for the development of chronic bronchitis. And keep it in your mind that cigarette smoking not only damage the lining of the airway, but also affect on the ciliary action. And due to defect of these ciliary action, there is a which prevent the clearance of the mucus production or clearance of over excess of mucus. So it increases the risk of infection. Clear? Now, morphological features of chronic bronchitis. Grossly, there is a hyperemia, swelling, and edema of the mucous membrane with excessive mucus or mucopurulent secretions. And microscopically, beta, mild chronic inflammation of the airways, mainly of lymphocytes, and enlargement of the mucus secreting glands of trachea and bronchi. Number of goblet cells increases, but major changes is in the size of the mucus gland. This increase can be assessed by thickness of the mucus gland layer to the thickness of the wall between the endothelium and the cartilage, which we call a reed index. Beta, as we know that in a chronic bronchitis, there is an increased mucus gland, so the increased number of goblet cells causes the increase the size of mucus gland, and there is the increased thickness of the mucus gland layer. So which cause the increase in the Reed index. Reed index is normally 0.4. Okay, and Reed index is basically an index. Is basically a index between the mucus gland layer thickness and the mucus gland layer thickness and the thickness to the wall between the endothelium and cartilage. The mucus gland ki thickness increase ho rahi hai, to uski wajah se Reed index bhi hamara increase ho jayega, which is normally 0.4. While in chronic bronchitis, the Reed index increases. Clear? The bronchial epithelium may show squamous metaplasia and dysplasia. Okay, and in severe cases, obliteration of the lumen due to fibrosis, which we call a bronchiolitis obliterans. Clear? So now the clinical features. But a clinical feature is basically in a chronic bronchitis, there is a persistent cough with productive cough. Okay, persistent cough productive of squamous sputum. Dyspnea on exertion develop. Okay, but dyspnea is basically a features of emphysema, and cough with productive cough is basically a features of chronic bronchitis. Other elements of COPD develop, including hypercapnia, hypoxia, and mild cyanosis. That's why the chronic bronchitis patients are also said to be a blue blotters. And severe chronic bronchitis may lead to the cold pulmonary and cardiac failure. So, as far as your exam is concerned, you must prepare your today's topic of obstructive lung disease in such a way that you must know about the definition or proper definition of chronic bronchitis and emphysema. You must know the diseases which includes in a COPD, okay? And the pathogenesis of emphysema and chronic bronchitis, clear? Different type of emphysema, clear? And the complication of chronic bronchitis, because this is frequently asking the OSPI as well, what are the complications of chronic bronchitis? It can be asked among them, it can be asked in your MCQs that among the following, which one is the complication specific with chronic bronchitis? So cold pulmonary cardiac failure is basically a complication of a chronic bronchitis. Clear? So in the last bit, we will compare the features of chronic bronchitis with the emphysema. Clear? By this chart is very important, and this chart is from your book, Robbins. And the chronic bronchitis is commonly seen in a young patient as compared to emphysematous patient. Dyspnea is a major feature of emphysema. Okay, while a cough is basically a feature of chronic bronchitis. Clear? Infection is commonly seen in bronchitis because of, as we discussed earlier, that due to overproduction of mucus and due to smoking, the effect in the ciliary action and the excess mucus cannot be removed. So it is responsible for the development of an infection. Okay. And the respiratory stop together. So, beta. Okay. Achha, beta. And then the cold pulmonary, I already told you that it is complication of chronic bronchitis. Elastic recoil, beta, is basically the fact that low elastic recoil tendency is low in emphysema because there is a destruction in the alveolar wall. Okay, and the beta, chronic bronchitis patient is basically said to be a blue blotters, while the emphysematous is basically a pink puffer. Okay, so there is this is all about the emphysema and chronic bronchitis. Beta, tomorrow we will discuss about the remaining obstructive lung disease like asthma and bronchiectasis. Okay, if you have any query, beta, you can ask. आ जाए
okay.
जी